Big mistake. Sits down, opens it up, and thousands of pounds of sand pour out, along with a palm tree and the occasional crab. Apparently, she won a 2-week vacation to a beach. Fantastic. That's what I would want when I open a letter. Thousands of pounds of sand. I want it to be the town's litter box. Super. But I don't ever go to my mailbox and question what I'm gonna get inside. Hey, I got a letter. I wonder if there's thousands of pounds of sand in it. Doesn't feel heavy. Maybe I'll take it inside and open it up. All right, guys, that's all I got for right now. Up next is my good friend, Jared Wilson. He'll be singing to you. Have a good night.
And I was checking out the side of the box and noticing that there's actually two full sets of directions to cook a Pop-Tart on the side of a box. There's toaster directions, and there's also microwave directions. I guess the most amazing thing to me is that the toaster directions are actually longer than one step. You'd think that the toaster directions would read, step number one, toast the Pop-Tarts. Go ahead, toast them. It's okay. Hey, are you still reading this? But instead, they've broken up the toaster directions into some smaller increments. Actual instructions aside, and I'd really like to, by the way, I'd really like to be in the room when somebody actually needs to consult the directions when making a Pop-Tart. Step number one, remove pastry from pouch. Okay, yeah, I see where they're going here. We're banging on all cylinders now. Step number two, insert pastry vertically, vertically, into toaster. I gotta get me a toaster. I guess even more amazing are the microwave instructions. I gotta tell you, if you don't have a minute and a half to toast a Pop-Tart, you probably want to consider loosening up your schedule. But the microwave directions read, step number one, remove pastry from pouch. Step number two, place pastry on a microwave-safe plate. There goes that whole, you know, microwaving on tinfoil idea I had. And then microwave on high for 3 seconds. No joke, check your local grocer. On the side, microwave for 3 seconds. I can't imagine life like that. Your alarm goes off, 3 seconds go by, ding, I gotta get out of here. All right. Except a young lady who I'm sure also appreciates a good Pop-Tart in the morning, Kelly Corvo. I've heard that she can play a mean violin. And we're gonna get the chance to hear that in just a minute, a piece entitled My Happy Ending.
I'm
Well, anyone who's had me in class, I think, can probably tell you I'm a pretty hip and happening kind of guy. I'm what they call a cool cat. A lot of them can tell you that I also work at Market Basket on the side. For fun, a little hobby of mine, there this morning. And the interactions I have with the youth at the store are a little bit different in character than those that I have with the students here at school. For instance, there's one guy who comes up to me the other week and tells me, "You are the bomb." My response to that was, "Hey, you want to take this outside a little few?" I can remember when bombs were bad and blew up people. I can also remember when being called fat was an insult, but I guess now being called a fat bomb means you're really, really cool. There's another kid that says, "Yo, yo, I'm feeling ya." No, you're not. You're not even going to get to first base with me, okay? And no yo-yo. Someone else says to me, "You're my dog." Well, then why don't I make friends with your leg and poop on the rug? Last year, someone outside the town show said, "Yo, you was mad funny. I ain't fronting. You know what I'm saying?" Actually, no, I have no clue what you just said. So I guess if I want to maintain my reputation as a hip and happening cool cat kind of dude, I guess I just gotta put on some bling, quit acting crunk, learn the lingo, drop it like it's hot with my homies. And then finally I'll be deaf and get some digits from some shorty. That was ill. Another hip and happening kind of guy coming up next. A.J. Chase, performing his original song, "Without You."
How's everybody doing? Little loud.
Empty roads that call my name, constantly bringing me to shame. You told me you would leave me here, like you said, you've up and disappeared. Regretting how you talk to me, now I look at more and you're not there, yeah, yeah. You're not there, yeah, yeah, yeah. 'Cause now you're gone, yeah, you left all of these little things to get off my chest. Don't leave now, just Without you, don't leave.